Hi, welcome to the tutorial on HFSS. In this video tutorial, I would like to demonstrate the design of patch antenna. The antenna is designed at a frequency of 5.2 GHz. This is the geometry of the patch antenna. The width of the substrate is 35.9 mm and the length is 58.94 mm. The length of the patch is 17.56 mm and the width is 12.56 mm. The edge feed length is having a width of 3.059 mm and its length is 14.895 mm. The patch and the edge feed are connected through a lambda by 4 transmission line, which is having a width of 0.723 mm and its length is 8.294 mm. So, in this tutorial, I am going to design this patch antenna using HFSS tool. So, this is the default GUI of HFSS. First, I have to create a substrate. So for creating the substrate, draw a box which is a 3D shape. And immediately rename it as substrate. The material used is FR4. You can search here FR4 epoxy, which is having relative permittivity of 4.4 and loss tangent of 0.02. Click OK. You can select the colors of choice. Click Apply. OK. Now the material has been set. Double click on this to set the length and width of the substrate. The substrate X size is 35.9 and Y size is 58.9 and the Z size is, height of the substrate is 1.6. And it is positioned at minus 17.95, which is half of the X size, and the Y value is taken as 0. Z axis is minus of 1.6. So you can click on fit all to see the substrate. You can use the rotate option here by clicking on this. Now if you see that the substrate is always placed, or it is better to place the substrate below the zero during the fabrication process. Now over the substrate or under the substrate, place a ground plane. Use the draw rectangle, click on this, it's a 2D shape, double click on this and name it as ground. You can change the color, click on apply, change the dimensions, double clicking on it. The dimensions of the ground is the same as that of the substrate. So 35.9 and 58.9. It is again placed at minus 17.95. Y value is taken as 0 and Z direction is minus 1.6. Click on apply. Okay. If you rotate it, now you can see the color, which is a pink. It's a ground plane. The ground plane is below the substrate. Over this substrate, try to place a patch, which is again a rectangular in shape. Use the 2D shape, you can draw anywhere. I want to place the patch here at the middle. So rename it as patch. You can change the colors. Click apply. Okay. Just double click on it and change the patch dimension. As we have mentioned, the patch is having a length of 17.56 mm and 12.56 mm. So the same dimension I am going to mention here. That is, X size is 17.56 and Y size is 12.56. And this patch is placed at a midpoint, which is 8.78. And 23.19 with the Z as 0. So it is placed here. Next, you create a feed line. This is the feed line with the length 14.895 and width as 3.059 mm. So again, use the draw rectangle. Can draw anywhere because we can change the dimension. Click on it and rename it as edge feed. You can change the color, change the dimension of this edge feed. Edge feed dimension is, or the X size is 3.059, which is the width, and its length is minus 14.895, that is in minus Y direction. It is placed at half of this first X size, minus of 1.5255, and Y size is exactly 14.896. Click on apply. Okay. So this is the edge feed. Now, since the impedance of this feed line is 50 ohm and impedance of this patch is 240, so you need a quarter wave transmission line to connect these two. So again, use a draw rectangle, connect this, or you have to create one more rectangle and name it as quarter wave. Which have a wavelength of lambda by 4. Click on OK, apply. And this quarter wave is having a width of, you see this structure, it is having a width of 0.723 mm and its length is 8.294 mm. The width of 0.723 mm and length of minus 8.294 mm, and exactly place it at as we specified for the feed line. It is minus 0.3615, which is half of this value of 0.723, and Y value is 23.19, and Z value is 0. Click apply. Okay. Now these are connected. Phytol. Now you need to connect all these. Select the patch, feed, and quarter wave. Then click on unite, because you need to unite all these structure into a single one. Click on unite. Now you can see that all are united. Save the design. Save the design. If you see that the patch and the ground both are two-dimensional structures which we have created by using the draw rectangle option. We did not specify any material definitions to them. So there is no thickness also. If you rotate and see that there is no thickness to them, that's why we have to assign them. So select the patch and ground, right click on it and click on assign boundary and click on perfect E. Now if you want to see that what we have assigned the boundaries, that is the patch and the ground plane now acts as a perfect conductors. Because there is no thickness, we have assigned them as a perfect conductors. Now once we have created this, you need to excite this port by using the or connecting a port. So just rotate it and connect the port, or you can select this model. Just zoom in. You have to create the port for feeding. Use one more rectangle here. Draw a rectangle. We know that its width is, let me change the axis to ZX. Now you draw the rectangle to it. So I have created the rectangle. Rename this rectangle as port. Double click on it. And we know that the size of this is 3.059 mm. 3.059 mm, and the Z size already dimension is 1.6 mm. Next, once the port is defined, you need to provide the excitation. So right click or select the port, right click, assign excitation, select the lumped port. So the impedance of that port is 50 ohm. Click next. Now define the new line. To define that, you can see the triangle here. You select this point and drag this to the upper point. It says that define. Click on next. Full impedance is 50 ohms. Finish. To see that excitation, you can click on here. So this is how the port is assigned. So we have connected the port. Since the antenna has to be radiated, it has to be done, or you have to create an environment. You need to create an environment. To do that, either you can do the manually, the work can be done manually, or you can ask the tool to do it automatically. That is, you have to create a radiation box surrounding it. You need to create a radiation box. So what I am going to do is just right click here and you can create the open region. So select the operating frequency at what you have to 5.2 gigahertz. You are assigning the radiation boundary. So this is how you assign, or manually you have to create by selecting the draw box. So you can see how the open is there and perfect E is assigned. This is the draw box or environment where the antenna is simulated. You can see the structure. This box can be done manually also. Once this is done, we have completed the modeling, we have assigned the boundaries, and we have performed this. Or if you want to select what type of a boundary you have given, you just double click on it to see you have given the material as vacuum. Instead of that, we'll select the air as a medium. You can search for the air as a medium, click OK and apply OK. Now you have set the medium as air, or you can select go with the vacuum. Once we have defined all this, so excitation has been done. Next, you need to give the or set up the analysis. So right click on it, add the solution setup. Select the operating frequency of 5.2 gigahertz. I want to have a maximum number of passes of 20. Okay. You again click on the analysis and select this setup one, right click, add frequency sweep. Here you can select either fast, interpolating, discrete of your choice. I am selecting it as to be a fast, and I want to linear count, that is from 2 gigahertz to 7 gigahertz. Maximum frequency is 7 gigahertz, and I want to have 401 points. So if you want, how many points are there, you can see this. You can close this, you can save the radiated fields only, click OK. Once we have set the analysis, you have to validate the design. You need to validate the design. So whether the design will pass or not, we have to check it. So how to check it is, go to the HFSS, validation check. So if every step has been followed correctly, it gives with the green tick mark. Else you will have wrong. If any step is missing, means that step will be given as a wrong. Since we have completed all the steps successfully, you can close it. Once the structure is analyzed or validated, you need to perform the, or you have to analyze this structure for the given simulated frequency. So to do that, go to the HFSS, analyze all, click on the analyze all. Just click on it. You can see the progress window here. So it's analyzing the structure for the frequencies. You can see the progress bar. So it takes some time for analysis because is starting from 2 gigahertz to 7 gigahertz. So definitely it takes certain amount of time because the number of points is 401. So it takes around 30 seconds or so. Let us wait for the results. Once the process completes, you can move down to the results section. Here. From here, you can plot the resonating frequency of the antenna and how it is radiating. So it shows that the progress bar is still going on. It is taking time. So the progress bar shows that it has completed the simulation. Now you can go to the results section, right click on it, create model solution data report, rectangular plot. Here you have to select the S parameter because you want to see the S11 parameter in terms of dB. Click on new report. Close this window and you can see that how the antenna structure is radiating. So to see the maximum point or the S11, right click marker, add marker, end marker. So you can see that the antenna is radiating at a frequency of 5.1875. Actually the design structure is 5.2. But now, because of the given specification, the antenna is radiating at a 5.1875 gigahertz with minus 36.3278 dB. So it is radiating, but not exactly at 5.2, but 5.18. So this can be optimized by using some optimetrics, which we will discuss in the next video. Next, we'll try to plot the radiation plot for this. Right click on it, insert far field, infinite sphere. So change the value, phi as the 0, and I want 360 degrees, next step size of 10. And theta value to be 0, 180 and 10. Click OK. Then go to the result section again. Right click here. This time create far field reports 3D polar plot. You can select the RE, that is to plot the electric field in terms of dB. You can select it, click new report. It will plot the radiation plot. If you want to rotate this, you can rotate this structure. This is how. So for 0, 5 or for theta equal to 0, the maximum radiation is happening in the z-axis. So let me close this. If you want to see the structure again, if you want to get the structure, you can right click, plot fields, radiation field. If you want to see that onto the structure, actually we have the structure will appear here if you see that, but the antenna will be radiating here. Since the access point we have taken from minus 17, now the origin point is 0. For 0 value, it is radiating maximum in the z direction. So just unmark this and apply, close. Now, if you want to see the how the electric field and H field exist, you can right click on it, plot fields, and select the E field vector E. So first I have to select the geometry, that is go to the patch, select the patch, then plot fields E vector E, select all objects, done. Again it is performing the simulation and you can see them in the field overlays option here, field overlays. Just right click and animate. So click OK, that's all. Shows the E field radiation. If you want to change this, you can do it. So that is right click on this bar, modify, set the scale, use the limits, that is right from zero. Just click on apply. It is performing again the simulation. So you can see how the antenna structure is having the E fields. In the similar manner, you can go with the H fields also. So select the patch again, plot fields, H and vector H. Click all objects, done. Now you are having the E field and H field. So just right click and animate. You can see that E and H field radiation, or you can change the values if you want. So only few points I have discussed here. There are other options. In the previous tutorial I have explained design of microstrip patch antenna. In the next tutorial I will explain how to perform the optimization. We see that we have got the results, that is S11. Let me delete this E field and H field. I am deleting. Let me go to the model. Let me go to the model, then go to the S11. Double clicking on it. So I want to perform the optimization of this. That is exactly at 5.2 gigahertz. I want this value. So in the next video, I'll present the optimization, how to perform the optimization. So we have the tab or option called as the optimetrix, where you can add, analyze, and tune. So there are other options. In the next video, we'll try to discuss that. Thank you.